Assalamu alaikum to everyone. Is my voice clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's start.
Yes, sir.
I was sitting free, so I thought that I should talk to you if you are free, so you can give your presentation and get rid of these presentations. Because we don't have much time, ज़्यादा वक्त हमारे पास नहीं है. Maybe 10 तारीख तक हमें अपना course complete करना पड़े, so I have to take your classes as well. So I thought that I should do it. क्योंकि हमारी माह रमजान में क्लासेस काफ़ी मिस हुई थी, उससे इसके अलावा भी एक आध वीक में मिस हुई थी बिकॉज ऑफ योर मिड टर्म एग्जाम्स एंड अदर योर ऑनलाइन एग्जाम्स एंड अदर थिंग मिड टर्म एग्जाम्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. इज मानू रिसाब प्रेजेंट?
यस सर.
स्टार्ट प्लीज.
ओके, अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे द प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक व्हिच इज गिविंग व्हिच आई एम गिविंग दैट इज
Speak loudly.
Using
dictionary
for activities.
Yeah, speak loudly, please. And
BS or MA? MA English, fifth semester.
Okay.
So change the slide.
MA
okay.
English.
Okay. Now.
MA English.
Yes, sir. BS, fifth semester.
Okay.
Yes, sir. So should I?
Yes.
Okay, before starting anything, I would must tell you about the definition of dictionary. That is a book or electronic resource that lists the words of language typically in alphabetical order and gives their meaning or gives the equivalent words in a different language, often also providing information about pronunciation, origin, and usage. It is very helpful resource for educational purposes. We can get know meanings of the word clearly. If you are using dictionary in our daily life, we can solve our many problems. If we are reading novels and anything, we can find its meaning, the words we do not know. So change the slide. Sir, change the slide. Now, using dictionary for classroom activities, there are a number of activities which we can use by using dictionary. That is, I would like to tell you some advantages of that. It develops students' autonomy, like they become able to learn by themselves. And on the other hand, the bilingual dictionaries enables the student to understand the meaning of the words quickly. It also helps students develop to a more natural command of English. And these activities by dictionary will enhance learners' confidence. Now, the last is, these activities make learners fast. When they use dictionary, they will not take much time if they are habitual of using dictionary, and things will be properly memorized to them. So next. Now, there are some activities which can which can train our student by those their language will be improved and they will use more effectively. Now, the first activity, but before doing any activity, we must keep in mind that we know in language class we have all kind of age group and have different level. So prepare your activities according to their level. They have to clear the concept. Now, the first activity is alphabetical order. This is what we must tell the students to use dictionary. For that, give each student some letters and then tell them to arrange these in orders. Then take them to the dictionary to show this to them and ask them to look these alphabetical orders. This will help them to find words in the dictionary. If you are telling them to write come or to find come in the dictionary, then they will go to dictionary and they will search COM and then they will get their letter. It is for the young learners. Now, second activity is, a speedy game, a speedy word game. It is all about listening. Teacher has to speak a word and student has to listen that. And he has to find that word quickly into the dictionary. And this should be rapid fire round. It means that you have to give them some, you have to tell them to do it quickly and will make them fast to research word. And this will become their habit. And it will enhance their listening skills also. So next, the third activity is word families. When you teach part of speech to your student, after teaching that, give them a word, for example, success, and then tell them to find its adverb, adjective, like successful, successfully, and succeeded. This will be very helpful to find more part of a speech, and they will get their meanings also. So their vocabulary will be enhanced by this. There is another word, incorrect, correct, correctly, correction. So this will be better for learning part of speech. So next. So change the slide. Now the fourth activity is dictionary race. It is what give dictionary to all students and give them some new words and ask them to find its meaning in the dictionary, and do also give them some seconds or minutes so that they can become enthusiastic and it will take interest in order to, they will take interest in order to win that game. It will be more fun with learning and they will find more words in according to the race. We know vocabulary plays a very important part in learning a language. So this will be very grateful, great activity if you are putting them in race. So next. The fifth activity is article reading and find words. It is what give any newspaper or article to your student and tell them to write some difficult vocabulary from this into your notebook and then find its meaning from dictionary. There is a twist that you also can give them exchange, like then exchange these unmeaning words to other classmates and find those too. This activity will be very helpful for reading and finding meaning. Their reading will be very good if they are doing this activity. Give bilingual dictionary to your young learners. If you teaching adult, to give them Oxford dictionary so that it will be according to their knowledge. Now the last activity is give them sentence and three words, ask them what to find them dictionary. It is what give them give your students three words, like give them a sentence, I go to school. Now do not write go, just give them three MCQs, like three options, that is go, have, and do, and tell them to find all these three words in the dictionary. Now what will happen, they will get to know that go means when we walk or do, and have, do. Now they will get to know that what to put here. They will find all three meanings and then they will pick the sweet table. So this will be very helpful for them. Like there is an other example, don't dash a noise. Now give them three options, do, make, and keep, and tell them to find these words in the dictionary. This actually increase their knowledge and this will be very, they will not get any trouble in vocabulary. Thank you so much, sir. If we are doing all these activities in classroom, so it will be very grateful. These activities will enhance learners to use dictionary confidently and enhance vocabulary. And we know that vocabulary is a deep water. If you are going to the vocabulary, we will find number of words. Thank you, sir.
सर काइंडली मेरी प्रेजेंटेशन ले लो, मुझे संडे मास पे जाना है.
Yes, Mr. Shahzad, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Start.
Good morning, everyone. Today, my topic is, what is writing? Define its purpose. So first of all, I would like to tell you what writing is. Now, basically, writing is the piece of your thoughts or the ideas that you want to convey to the readers. Writing is an art of expressing our thoughts and views. Writing is a mean of communication that is made possible through the graphic symbols, arrangements, and certain sentences that are used in day-to-day language, in day-to-day conversation, that are grammatically connected to form a piece of writing. So next slide, please.
Speak loudly.
Writing skills include all the knowledge and abilities related to expressing ideas through the written word. Technical knowledge about writing, convention, study, style, guides, and formatting for different situations are also a part of skill writing skills. Now, what basically styles are? The styles include the expository one, the descriptive one, the persuasive one, and the informative one. That is the creative writing and all are included in the styles. Sir, please change the slide. Now, what are the different stages of writing? Now, writing is not just a piece of cake. It is a whole lot of process. It involves different type of steps within it. The first one is pre-writing. Now, what pre-writing is? Pre-writing includes the brainstorming. It includes the knowledge about the topic. It includes the choosing of the topic. The selection of the topic is very much important. The selection of the vocabulary, the selection of the words. Then comes the second stage, that is drafting. Now, what basically drafting is? Drafting means that when you are writing something, you write all your thoughts that comes into your mind. When you are out of your writer's block, you write whatever comes in your mind. And then in the revising step, you pick out the sentences, you pick out the paragraphs, you pick out the main points, the facts or the key points. And then in the editing one, you check out the punctuations, the spelling mistakes, the vocabulary, and all the rest of the things that are need to be rectified in a piece of a writing. So please kindly change the slide. Sir, am I audible? Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, what does drafting mean here?
Sir, drafting here means when you are writing something, you are creating a draft. You are writing something that is not appropriately a piece of paper or piece of writing that can be published or that can be given anywhere. It is just your thoughts that you have written. The first draft that you have written is drafting here.
That is called first, second draft, right? Draft.
Yes, sir. First writing draft. The purpose of writing. Now, there are basically mainly three purposes of writing. There can be many more, but I have picked out these three mainly. The first one is to express. The second one is to inform. And the third one is to entertain. Now, what basically to express is? Sir, kindly change the slide. To express means in a form. In this form, the writer expresses their personal thought and the view and their view point of view on the certain topic. Now, it is basically the examples are the articles, or you can say the books, the newspaper, or you can say the speeches, the essays are an example of to express. That is in this form, writer express their thoughts and their opinion about a certain topic. The second one is to inform. So kindly change the slide. To inform, in this type of writing, the writer informs the reader.
Voice not coming.
Of the writer, the influential articles that are used, the research paper, the report writing, that are used to inform about the facts, about the factual things that are relating to the certain topic. The third one is to entertain. So kindly change the slide. To entertain, in this type of writing, the writer wrote fictional and non-fictional stories. The main source is to give pleasure. It gives entertainment to the readers. Now, fiction and non-fiction are further divided into different genres. Fictional stories can be divided into fantasy, fictional history, history fiction, science fiction, and many more. Supernatural stories. Now, what are the techniques of writing, teaching writing? Now we are here, we are reading the subject of teaching of literature. So basically I want to enhance or add this point in my presentation, because in teaching the writing, how to teach the writing, these are the techniques. The first one is brainstorming. The teacher herself or himself needs to brainstorm the student. The second one is planning and rehearsing. The planning and rehearsing includes the discussion, the classroom discussion between the children, between the students and the teacher. Second comes the drafting or composing. Now the teacher should always, being a facilitator, the teacher should check the first draft of the student and help them composing their ideas. The fourth one is revising. Now the revising, the student himself and the teacher themselves help them revising into the matter to add up the facts, to add up the facts and figures or the remaining points that are need to be added. The last one is editing. Now editing, the teacher herself or himself should edit the material or the written work of the student and help the student to get their mind very much open, and they should tell their mistakes to the children so that next time they can rectify their mistakes and next time they don't perform the same silly mistakes that they have done in their previous writings. That's all, sir. Thank you. Sir, can you play Mind Face? Sir, can I leave the class?
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Fatima Muhammad Iqbal from MA. Today my presentation topic is the characteristics of good learners. Sir, next please. Yes, age factors. The age of the student is a major factor in our decision about how and what to teach. Exactly. As a teacher, their needs and understanding level. As I think, young learners learn faster than others, so we can't use same method for all because their skills and thinking power are not same. Next, sir. Okay, learners' characteristics with ages. Young learners learn quickly because their memorizing power is developing in this age. They get bored with same things like lectures and studying. They prefer activities like puzzles and role play. They learn easily with them. Adolescents and teenagers. They are also in good learning, but not as much as they can because they involve in many outdoor activities. They can't focus as much as they can. They're interested in playing, going outside and make friendship. Adult learner.
Okay,
they are
me.
Not
excuse
free
me.
Learners.
Excuse
they understand
me.
Things easily, but they are very
excuse
busy
me.
In their life.
Are you reading from somewhere
they
else?
They face problems.
Hello.
No, sir.
I think you're reading from somewhere because still the slide is same and you have gone up to adult learners. Secondly, here learners' characteristics, not characters. Characters, unke kya kahenge kirdar ko. हमने यहाँ बात कर ली इनकी खसूसियात लर्नर्स की खसूसियात क्या है क्लियर लर्नर्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स
जी सर वो आगे आएंगे लेकिन ये उनकी एज पे था
लर्नर्स कैरेक्टर्स क्यों लिखा आपने
सर वो आगे स्लाइड पे है ये उनकी एज पे था
लर्नर्स कैरेक्टर्स पे एज एजेस व्हाट डज इट मीन एक्सप्लेन इट एक्सप्लेन करने से क्या मतलब है सर
Yes, sir.
Learners characters with ages. Kya matlab hai iska?
Sir, iska matlab ye hai ki unke jo hai characters kis tarah se hain unke ages ke mutabik.
Characters ka to aapne ki to aapne abadi nahi ki characters ka matlab hota hai unka akhlaq.
जैसे कि वो किस तरह से
पढ़ते किस तरह से वो उनका रोल खिलाएगा कैरेक्टर नहीं खिलाएगा Learners' roles is according to their ages. Characters का मुझसे मुराद होता है उनका किरदार किरदार पे बात चली जाएगी कि वो अच्छे हैं बुरे हैं किस किस्म के लोग होते हैं ये होगा यहाँ तो आप बता रहे हैं उनके लेवल जो उन्हें क्या चीज अच्छी लगती क्या चीज तो you're talking about their roles. ये मैं कह रहा हूँ उसको आप करेक्ट कर लीजिए एंड प्लीज सी द स्लाइड एंड देन
ओके सर
यस कैरी ऑन
ओके Learners' character, sorry, role with ages, adult learners.
Speak loudly, please.
They are good and, sorry, sir. Okay. Adult learners. They are not free learners. They understand things easily, but they are very busy life, they face many problems like their job. मेरी आवाज आ रही है?
आवाज अब आ रही है लेकिन पहले नहीं आ रही है. यस
ओके. एडल्ट लर्नर्स, they are not free learners. They understand things easily, but they are very busy in their personal life. They face many problems in their, like their jobs, their family support, not appreciating, and their big problem is the lack of money. Okay, characteristics of good learners. Okay, the first one is willingness to listen. Good learners always focus on listen their teachers' lectures. They pay attention to verbal and non-verbal communication of teachers. Willingness to experience. Good learners, one of the best qualities, they're really capable to think out of the box. Willingness to ask questions, clear their topics and get information about their field. Okay, willingness how to study. Good learners always play each and everything. They find tips for better understanding. Willingness to accept correction. Good learners, one of the best qualities is this. They take the correction, their mistakes. They learn with their mistakes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, is Manur present? Yeah, is she present?
Sir.
Yeah, start please.
Sir, can you hear me clearly?
Yes.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum. This is Pratyan Baloch, a master student from the Department of English Literature and from the 8th page, section A, and this is my first semester. Next slide, please. Right now, all I'm going to talk about is literature, and these are the objectives and outline, you can call it, that going to be light up in today's session. What is literature, its origin, importance, Plato and literature, Geoffrey Chaucer about literature, its genres, elements, and lastly, I will summarize it. Next slide, please. What is literature? Before emphasizing, I just want to clear one thing that, excuse me sir, give me just 2 minutes, because yahan pe voices aa rahi hai.
Please request your family member to stay.
Yes sir, I did it. Sorry for, sorry for that. My bad. Before emphasizing, this slide, I just want to clear one thing, that don't you guys think that literature has got just single definition, because it's pretty wrong. Literature has got a couple of definitions in the various aspects, but as we are students, so we will focus it and consider it according to the educational settings. Literature according to educational setting, literature, okay, importance of literature. What I personally believe about literature is its importance, that literature improves our command of language. It teaches us about the life, cultures, and experiences of people in other parts of the world. It gives us information about other parts of the world which we may never be able to visit in our lifetime. It entertains us and provides useful occupations in our free time. Lastly, this is the most important thing that I do believe about the literature, is it makes us wiser and more experienced person by forcing us to judge, sympathize with, or criticize the character we read about. A part of it, it helps us to compare our own experiences with the experience of the other people. It gives us information which may be useful in other subjects like geography, science, history, social studies, and so on. Next slide, please. Next slide, please, sir. Okay, it is the most interesting thing what Plato has said about the literature. According to Plato, literature is the mere imitation of life, means the literature is the mirror of life. And I do believe that literature can be the reflection of life and society and human experiences. Literature allows people to relive their memories, share the same experiences to the writer. Literature can be considered as a mirror of life in terms of reflecting the things or the aspects that people encounter in their daily life. Literature acts as a form of expression for each individual. Most importantly, literature helps us to understand the kind of things that are not easily understood and comprehended, like pain, hatred, love, death, war, sacrifices, and etc. So would you mind, would you like to change the slide, please? Yeah, the father of literature, Geoffrey Chaucer. I personally love Geoffrey Chaucer because he was the one who decided to write in English, even though knowing that the dominating language is French. The way he proved his determination and bravery is just mind-blowing. And he's best known for this and well-recognized by the title of Father of Literature or English Literature. Chaucer influenced literature by inspiring the other poets, author, and playwright who followed him. Next slide, please. Yeah, the four main literary genres are poetry, fiction, non-fiction, and drama. Poetry is emotion-based, emphasis on image or feeling, more emphasis on rhythms and meter than other genres. And fiction is a kind of prose created from the imagination, maybe based on real events or people, but not changed by the constraint of reality. It is plot-based, basically. And non-fiction is totally true, and it is the character best organized through paragraphs and a couple of things ahead. Drama is a characterless, character names indicate who's speaking, and organized by act, scene, and line numbers may include stage, direction, but may not. It is play plot based. Next slide, please. Yeah, basic elements of literature: plot, characterization, setting, and theme. The plot is made up of series of cause and effect events that lead the reader from the beginning of the story through the middle
these are not the parts of literature. These are the parts.
Sir, who
of,
said?
These are not the parts of literature. These are the parts of novel, fiction, or you know, you can find this thing in poetry. These are the forms
sir,
of
what?
Literature. Are you getting me? Literature includes all
yeah,
these.
But
literature.
Yes, sorry, I cannot hear you.
I'm saying that these are not the parts of literature. These are, you know, the parts of fiction, novel, drama. Even
so these are the elements, na basically the form.
Elements, literature ke elements nahi hai beta, literature ke nahi hai. Literature to form hai, form hai aur drama.
Genres ke hai na, jo genres hain uske.
Literature kya? Achha, dusra hai. Chaucer.
Fiction, non-fiction, drama and all.
Chaucer is not the father of literature. He is the father of English poetry. ठीक है बेटा, ये थोड़ा correction कर लीजिए.
सर एक सर जो मैंने बहुत अच्छे से उसको रिसर्च करके किया आई थिंक यू मस्ट रिसर्च इट अहेड प्लीज सर डू नॉट माइंड इट बट मैंने बहुत इसको सर्च करने के बाद आई रोट दैट के इट इज द फादर ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर बेसिकली
कहां से आपको वो आप मुझे रिसोर्सेज वो सोर्सेज बताएगा जहां से आपने
या आई विल सेंड यू द रिसोर्सेज आई विल सेंड यू द
ऑथेंटिक होनी चाहिए ठीक है
Yeah,
literature is a form. Literature is a form. Remember, Chaucer, जो था सिर्फ poetry में जोता पर ही वाज द फादर ऑफ पोएट्री नॉट नॉवेल फिक्शन प्रोज द लिटरेचर तो सबको इंक्लूड करता है
सर नॉट फ्रॉम द जस्ट वन सोर्स दैट आई गॉट दैट आंसर जितने भी थे आई विल सेंड यू
ओके तो आप रेफरेंस लाजमी भेजिए क्योंकि रेफरेंस लिस्ट
आप या आई विल सेंड यू पर्सनली
ओके थैंक यू
वेरी मच सर ओके
Shumaila Arshad present? Shumaila Arshad? Irshad, sorry.
Yes, sir.
Shumaila Arshad present?
Yes, sir.
So I'm playing your presentation. Here we go. Start.
Yes, sir.
Yes, wait.
जी सर स्टार्ट
स्टार्ट
यस सर सर जस्ट अ मिनट सर आई एम स्टार्टिंग
We are losing time, hurry up.
Sir, my presentation is receptive skills. So there are in any language there are four basic skills. Receptive skills are also known as passing skills. Receiving information by listening and reading.
Whatever slide
sir,
you have.
Practices are.
जो स्लाइड सामने उसको बताएगा
सॉरी सर
व्हाटएवर स्लाइड यू हैव इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर स्क्रीन टेल अबाउट दैट स्लाइड
यस सर यस सर जो तुम्हारी सर जो प्ले कर रहे वो नहीं हो रहा
यस सर या वी आर
सर If we want to learn any language, we are four basic skills. Sir, next slide. Sir, there are, these are reading, listening, speaking, and writing. So among them, reading and listening are receptive skills, and writing and speaking are productive skills. So my topic is receptive skills. So sir, reading in this is there, reading and listening is included. Sir, receptive skills are necessary for the many sources of information. Without the ability to read, one would not know how to use any information that is present in these material. Sir, listening means when we listen, when we hear something, and to give consideration and to be alert to catch these words by sound. So this is known as listening skill. Sir, next slide. Sir, there are five types of listening. First is discriminative listening. Differentiate the sound of voice. For example, the example is given here. Sir, types को define करना है या नहीं? Sir, define कर दो.
Do whatever you have decided, please. Time is short.
Sir, I have given an example here. Like
example थोड़ा define करना होगा.
जी सर Sir, like a Canadian person named John sits in Karachi International Airport in Pakistan, at the same time two Pakistani peoples are speaking in, but he is distinguishes that who is male or who is female based on the type of voice or can identify the age. Thus, discriminative listening helps to identify gender, anger, happiness. Sir, discriminative listening is identifying the voice by sound. This is first type. Sir, next slide. Sir, next is comprehensive listening. Understanding the meaning of the message. Sir, in this, we want to understand the meaning of the message, that what is meaning is what a person wants to say. Third is empathetic listening, means understanding the feelings and emotions of the speaker. For example, the audience is thinking about the same thing that the speaker thinking. Empathetic listening is known as the understanding the feelings and emotions of the speaker. That what is he describing us? What is he? What does he want to say us? Sir, next slide. Fourth is analytical listening. For example, that speakers are showing a statistical audience to persuade audience, although audience argue with others for better understanding. Sir, when we want to analyze any listening, whatever a person is saying or speaking to us, when we analyze that thing, it is known as analytical thinking. Appreciative listening, it is a type of listening behavior where a listener seeks certain information which they will appreciate and meet his or her needs or goals. For example, listening need or qualities. Sir, next slide. Active listening skills are like ask open-ended questions. Sir, open-ended questions are when we don't say that, when the questions are not in yes or no. Second is request, like clarification, be attentive, summarize, paraphrase, reflect feeling, be attenuate to feeling, ask probing questions. Sir, next slide. These are known as the active listening skills. Sir, reading skills are the abilities that pertain to a person's capacity to read, comprehend, interpret, and decode written language and text. Reading skills are abilities that pertain a person's capacity to read, comprehend, interpret, and decode written language and text. Reading comprehension is simply the ability to understand whatever you read. Sir, when we read something, I want to describe it that when we read something, then we there are many reasons behind it, that why do we read? For understanding anything, we read that. Thinking about what has happened and what is happening. Fluency and expressions, reading with the best storyteller voice, visualizing figures out difficult words. Other getting started, sir, listening skill activity. Sir, this is an activity, listening skill activity.
Okay, tell me about listening skill activity. Do we need any visual, audiovisual aid, or without audiovisual aid we can have this activity?
Sir, listening activity without the audiovisual aid, we cannot listen anything when we have a person or when we have any audio or visual things, audiovisual things we have in front of us, then we do any listening activity. Otherwise, how can we listen?
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, I'm sending another session link. So please, you those who are left, they can join the session. Or jinhone de diye, they can leave now. Right? They are not bound to continue the session. So wo log leave kar sakte hain. So those who have given their presentation, they can leave the session.
Sir, mera alayla Mumbai Sharon.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I'm sending you the resources that that you are willing to know. Should I send you just the snapshot? Yeah, personally in the WhatsApp. Just the snapshot or the exact link.
Image bhej dijiyega, theek hai? And the sources should be.
Yeah, okay. Okay, thank you so much.
No, I'm starting the new one.